Hello and welcome to RedStabler. In previous video, we have created a simple Lambda function which displays the data on the event object. Now we are going to show you how to use AWS API Gateway to invoke the Lambda function. On your AWS Service Console, select API Gateway. Select New API and choose the name and description, and then click Create API. First, you will need to create a resource. Your API can have many resources which can be called separately by its own URL path. Since we are going to call our Hello World Lambda function, let's name it Hello World and click Create Resource. Now we have the resource path. Next, we will create an access method for your API. So let's use get method. Choose Lambda function for the integration type. Then choose your Lambda region and your function name. When you are ready, click save and allow the invoke permission. Here's the diagram of your API flow. The client sends a GET request, which passed through Lambda integration. The function then executed and passed back as HTTP response back to the client. Now the API is ready, but before you can use, you need to deploy it. Click Action drop-down and select Deploy API. You need to specify which state you deploy your API to. For example, you can deploy API to your beta stage and test it. And once all defects has been identified and fixed, you can later deploy to prod stage when ready. For this tutorial, let's deploy to prod stage directly. Now you will get your stage URL, but if you access this URL directly, you will get an error. This is because we didn't define any access method for the root URL. If you remember, we have created Hello World resource, so we need to use the correct path for our resource. Now you can see that our function has been executed and returned correctly, except the undefined value. This is because in our Lambda function, we display the key one value on the event object. But since we didn't pass any query string or data, it will display as undefined. So in the next video, I'm going to show you how to pass the data on API URL to the Lambda function with event object. So that's it. If you like this video, please don't forget to like or subscribe to support us. Thanks!